Okay, so I don't know if you hear me over the wind or not. Here is I can't even say the name. Ruidoso, New Mexico. Right off of I-70 here. Between a bunch of mountains. Really beautiful area. You see here, I'm standing in front of the arts and crafts place. They're all family, but they're owned separately. Going to do an interview here with Fidel, his name is, and talk to him about his cedar and his poplar and his pine logs too. But as you can see, pretty good setup, nice backdrop, and we'll see how this works out.
As you can see here, it's a really big area, lots of carvings, and we're gonna go back here and see what they're doing. Go ahead.
I'm Fidel Figueroa. I'm a number of wood carvers for the last 14 years. And they're up in New Mexico.
And where are we at?
It's also New Mexico.
And this is Oscar.
Oscar.
he's the real guy, the guy that does all the real work.
What's it called? The Western Technical School.
Oh, okay.
But he kind of liked more the wood carving than what he went and learned and studied for.
Okay. What we have here is cedar.
Juniper.
This is juniper here?
Juniper. And then the big pile over there, we got the pine. And then we got another worker that's...
What do we got going over here?
This is where we set all the... right now we got bears that's gonna hold signs and some of them gonna hold fish. And just Chevy bears. So it's a run production with the chainsaw.
Oh, okay.
So that's what we do.
And that's what I interrupted you doing.
Yeah, and once we're done here, we got three people doing the hair with the hand grinder. And we got one on this side and two on the other side. Once they're done doing the hair, they also use the hand grinder with the sander to do the sanding for the hands. And that's where they bring all the detail for the face, the hands, and the feet. And they gotta use a lot of protection, like the air mask. They gotta protect their ears, and then the mask for the that way they don't get no chips in the eyes. So when they open new stores from Husqvarna Steel, Makita, we use their tools and just give them safety tips on how to use them. Chainsaws, grinders, drills. So every time they got a new store, they call us, hey, you interested? And we go up there and enjoy the day,
There you go. And, now what brand tools do you use the most? I mean,
The lightest chainsaw would be Husqvarna, but the one that lasts the longest would be Steel. And small tools like grinders, Milwaukee is good, but Makita is a little bit better and lighter. So it just depends. And DeWalt, it's a good one, but a hand grinder, I got the where the air comes out, it hits you in the face, so that's no good. You want the air to go through the other side.
Maybe we should drop them a line and tell them about that.
Yeah, they should change where the exit is, and that's it. So most of the wood, we don't cut it. It's just when they got a thin property in Ruidoso, that way the fire doesn't run as fast as normally they does. And also when they're doing construction houses, new houses, they got to clean the property. So instead of them paying to throw it away, they come and try to sell it at a reasonable prices, a little bit better than, and less work for us not to go and cut wood.
But it's so real reasonable prices, right?
Yeah, I mean, we don't feel that bad because they're cutting it, not us. So our saying is like we turn firewood into art.
There you go. I like that slogan. Here you can see Oscar's using a blowtorch to take off all the stray hairs and little burrs that are on there, and it gives us some definition as far as for burning the edge of the lines. Once he's done with that, he installs the eyes and does the detail paint with the black lines and such. And with all that being said, I guess I'll just leave you to take a look around here. You can see some of the bears and benches. All the benches look the same, but they look like they're handmade. So, as you can see, they also do steel work. And I didn't get to see any of that done, but maybe on my next trip. Well, here, I'll leave you to take a look around.